Adam Giles, a graduate of the professional writing program at U of T Mississauga, has published several pieces of short fiction and won the 2013 U of T Magazine Short Story Contest. He lives in Mississauga with his wife Amy and his daughters Isabella and Ariana. He'll be reading from his story, The Priorities Talk. Adam Giles.
As it happens, likes to go to bed early, which frees up my evenings for writing. So. Thank you.
You're not on record now.
Virginia cleans the house and gets in a yoga video and a shower before her parents arrive at noon. She plans to sit them both on the couch and lead in with something like, "Mom, Dad, Greg and I had a serious talk about our priorities, and they're just not lining up." They'll come back with something about giving it time, and she'll say she doesn't have any more time for Greg. Then she's going to lie and tell them that she's already seen someone else, a fellow teacher, a male one, to head off the lesbian thing. Her father had put it out there after one of Virginia and Greg's breaks last year. "Virginia, I'll love you either way," he said, "but are you sure you're attracted to men?" He was serious. Virginia doesn't make lunch for her parents. They've made a habit of stopping at Waldo's for burgers on the way, so they won't have to subject themselves to Virginia's concoctions. Mom and Dad aren't big on tofu, quinoa, pretty much anything from the grocery store's flaky aisle. She opens the door for them, and her mother is straightening out the bistro set on the porch. "You don't want somebody to trip over the legs on one of these things," she says to Virginia. "They'll sue you. City people are always suing each other, aren't they?" They come inside. Virginia asks them how their drive was, and her father is grumbling about city drivers. He draws a lot of honks for driving slower than the speed limit. He's the only person she knows who's ever been ticketed for impeding traffic. "People around here always got some place to be," he says. "They don't care if they're dead when they get there, so long as they get there quick." Virginia tells him he's right. "Can I get you anything? Coffee? Tea?" "Tea," her mother says. Her father waves off both options. "Beer, Dad?" Greg can left it in the fridge. "Not today." He touches his throat. "I'm fighting something." "Tea's good for that," Virginia says. "Some honey in it? It'll help. Kettle's on anyway." "Oh, all right." He sits on the couch. He sits where Shannon was sitting last night. It occurs to Virginia that Shannon has been around for almost 30 years now. The girl who told Virginia in high school that she was weird for always sitting alone in the cafeteria. The girl who brought Virginia into her group of friends. The girl who introduced Virginia to Greg in college. The girl who sat on her couch last night and asked her to be a surrogate. Virginia's dad passed the armrest. "So where's Greg?"